Hello there, my friends. Dan Deegan here. I wanted to talk to you today about something that's near and dear to my heart. And I won't be long today because I know I wrote a lot in this week's blog, but I want to talk to you about the difference between being a resource and a commodity to your customers. You know, when you're a resource, I mean, your customers come to you and say, listen, I have this opportunity to do this or to go into a new market. I don't know much about the new market, or I don't know much about this shipping process. Can you help me? As opposed to a commodity is, I need this done for this price. Can you do it? And yes or no. And actually, I should probably give you a little bit more context when it comes to a commodity, right? So a commodity is something where if you have a prospect or a customer that says, I'm going to send an email out to 5 different people and the best price gets it. That's the commodity market. And then I'm not talking about commodity as in a product. I'm just talking, there's so many people like you out there if you're doing that. When you're a resource, you're really at the top of your game, right? You're an expert. You understand market shifts. You understand strategic analysis. You understand what happens in specific areas at specific times a year. You know, this year was an unreal produce season compared to other years, right? So it's really understanding those shifts in markets and the strategy that goes behind it. But more than that, it's being a tool for your customer, a tool that no one else will be. You know, and that, again, that might be creating an SOP specifically strategically aligned with a customer's specific way of shipping. That might have to be going to market and getting that SOP really solidified and finding partners that are going to do it. That's all part of being a resource, right? It might be a strategic development of a big project that a customer has. And they say, you know, I want to give it to you and I want you to just run with it. That's part of being a resource, as opposed to saying, I need you to go from A to B. And if you go back to your customer and say, you know what, I know a better way, we've kind of done in the past, no, I don't want to hear about it, this is the way I need it done. That is in the commodity market, where you can see the difference when you start creating SOPs and generating that unreal product for your customers. That's in the resource market, right? So I urge you, I mean, I've given you a lot of information in the blog, so go there, read that information, because I urge you, today's day and age, we need more resources. We don't need commodity-driven salespeople. We need resource-driven salespeople. Our industry is taking a massive hit because of this, right? Rates are, in 2019, as we sit right now, heading into August, rates are at an all-time low. And it just can't keep happening. We've had 6 major bankruptcies. Now, yes, those bankruptcies could have been because of people not, you know, handling funds properly or whatever the case may be. But 99% of them come back and said rates are just not what they used to be. But this market, this industry, this everything we do, everything you see, taste, touch, and smell has touched a truck. So it's the number one market in the world. But yet rates are a bottom dollar. Drivers don't get treated the way they should be treated at companies. You know, it's a people industry. But yet so many people in this industry don't understand people skills or don't have them. So be that resource to your customers. Go out and sell yourself as a resource. Quit selling yourself as a commodity and digging with all the bottom feeders that are in this industry. The reality is we need to somehow get rid of them in order to build our industry up to what we want it. So go out there every day and sell yourself as a resource and crush your sales, my friend.